Okay, welcome back to Breakfast Daily. That was an interesting interview there with Kwaku Anyidoho, the Bull. Very, very solid interview there. And right now it's time for a relationship segment, in respect of which we have been joined by Emefa Chikata. You know her from Sister Sister as well. Good morning, Emefa.
Good morning.
How are you doing?
I'm good. I like the way you say my name with so much vim.
Emefa Chikata.
Yes.
No, there's a vim in there. I'm not sure what the Chikata means, but I know it's something powerful.
It has to do with rain or something.
With rain.
Yes. Echi Akata, I've been told, I think.
Yeah, that's right. Anyway, so moving on. This morning, something is just baffling me. I'm just wondering, so if you're in a relationship, right,
uh-huh.
and then you break up with your partner, then your friend who knew your partner maybe through you or however, even if you knew the partner before you, is it okay for that friend to be friends with your ex? Is it okay at all for your friend, maybe your best friend, or even a normal friend, to be okay with your ex when you've broken up with your ex?
You know what? When you said that, it's like my spirit was just rejecting that suggestion.
Why?
Okay, I think it depends on three things. Mm-hmm. I think it depends on the relationship you have with your friend. Like, how close are you guys?
Mm-hmm.
And how close are you to the ex? Whether it was before or during the relationship, that's number one.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, it depends on how they broke up.
Hmm.
If it was an amicable split, I think this question would be easier to answer. But if it was messy, then it's a bit of a gray area. And I think it also depends on your intentions as well.
As in you, the friend.
You,
being
the
friend.
With
the ex.
Yeah, because if you want to continue a friendship with your friend's ex because you had feelings for them or you found them attractive or you guys had a connection, then you also have to consider what will happen if you guys end up getting together.
But is it wrong to date your friend's ex?
I don't think it's necessarily wrong. Mm. I think it depends on, again, how they broke up and the time that has passed since the breakup. If that makes any sense. Because you don't want it to be soon after. It would look like you were having a relationship and you don't want to hurt your friend in the process as well.
So you want to delay like how long?
Not necessarily delay, but consider your friend's feelings. If you guys truly are that close, then don't go after their ex straight away.
But would you, for instance, in that situation, you need to ask your friend for permission. Like, yo, the way things are going, you know, your ex and I... We have become closer. Like, how does that conversation even come up?
I think it's how you say it, I think. I don't think it's necessarily asking for permission. I mean, we're all adults. People fall in love or people develop connections and attractions. If you simply say that or you have a conversation and let the person know that, listen, you didn't intend for this to happen, but this is what has happened. If they really want you to be happy, then they'll find a way to understand. It's all about adjustments, isn't it?
So but you tell the person you didn't intend for this. How did you not intend for this to happen?
Obviously,
when you were going out for dinners with my ex, did you not think this would happen? When you were spending time being a crying shoulder, did you not think this would happen?
That's what I'm saying. It depends on the time and it's how you say it and how you go about it, really. Because I think if you're doing something and you feel the need to hide it or to sugarcoat it, then you know there's something wrong with that dynamic. Do you get what I'm saying? So it depends on how you go about the whole situation. I don't think it's one size fits all. Definitely not. I think each relationship is different, and it's how you approach the situation.
Okay, so we took it a notch higher, whether it was okay to date your friend's ex. Because the argument is that if friends' exes are people to stay away from, you know, Ghana, for instance, is a small society. Accra, really, really small. And Accra is centralized in one small area.
Mm.
So if you're supposed to stay away from your friend's ex, I mean, take someone like me. I have a million friends. So if I'm supposed to stay away from...
And a million exes.
Kwaku Anyidoho will say, I will not answer to that one. We set the ground rules. Anyway, so if me, for example, I have like a million friends. So if each friend, okay, let's even say I have 500 friends, okay? And if each friend has at least five exes, it means there are 2,500 women in Ghana I cannot date, which does not seem fair.
Mm.
So it should be okay to date your friend's ex. I think we should
Or even, what did you ask me? Staying friends with them. Or now you're asking me, is it okay to date your friend's ex?
Yeah, I mean, I'm still on that, on that part. I'm just doing a sort of calculation.
Okay.
So if you have 500 friends, and each of the 500 friends have like five exes, it means there are 2,500 women who maybe fall in your category of women that you can date, that you cannot date. So if you have maybe for demographics, so this age gap, you have, let's say, 5,000 or let's say even 10,000 people in Ghana in that age gap. Mm. Already 2,500 are out because they are your friend's exes.
Yeah.
And the rest, maybe another 2,500 you might not find attractive. Another 2,500 may already be dating. So you are left with 2,500 out of 10,000. I think I did a solid calculation.
No, I just saw your face crumbling.
And out of that 2,500, maybe 2,000 of them will not like you back. So, so you have the 500 left.
Yeah.
Somewhere.
But the thing is, you're not close friends with all those friends. Like I said, it depends on how you go about it, honestly. I think, first of all, have the conversation with your friend. And just be honest. If you feel like you have to hide something, then you yourself, you feel like you're doing something wrong. Just be sensitive and go about it the right way in respecting everyone's feelings. And I also don't think you should hide it for too long, if that makes any sense. So perhaps give it like maybe a month or 2 months. Have a sit down with them.
A month or 2 months after the breakup.
After the breakup.
Is that not too soon?
Also, depending on how bad the breakup was. And how close you guys are. Just, you know, sow seeds. Let them know that you're spending.
You that you have gone to take your
You haven't taken
ex.
Anyone. They no, were already broken taken, up.
But you know, you are dating your friend's ex. Okay. A couple of months after they've broken up. And this, let's say this girl knows that Kofi and Kwame, you are friends. And then I'm dating Kwame now. I dated Kofi. We broke up. I'm dating Kwame now. Would you, Kwame, be comfortable if the lady is still friends with Kofi? Knowing the principle of Lai Momo. You know the Italian principle of Lai Momo? Old
no,
firewood
I, no,
burns,
I do not.
Burns fastest.
Mm,
yeah.
Does it?
It's Italian.
Oh, you just educated me this
morning. So old firewood burns fastest. So you know that he has been there before.
Okay.
He has surpassed that challenge before.
Yeah, so will you be comfortable? She's your friend's ex, and now you're dating her.
You're not dating
and
her.
Now you are still friends with that friend.
Yes.
Oh, that's
and now
very,
yes. So now the ex is still friends with the person they broke up with.
That's very messy. I always say that when you're going through a breakup, you're mourning the loss of a relationship and a friendship as well. So when you're entering a relationship, you have to have at the back of your mind that if this doesn't work out, you're losing a partner and you're potentially losing a friend.
No, but should you necessarily lose a friend?
Not necessarily,
because of a
but potentially you could, because trying to be friends straight after your breakup, number one, you're blocking your blessings. Your Mr. Right might be right around the corner, but because your ex is still in the mix, you have tunnel vision on, you know, staying friends, and you might not see the blessings that the universe is throwing at you. So that's number one. But I think if it's in your personality, if you are that chilled, that laid back, you can stay friends with your ex and be friends with someone that they dated and you guys can work it out, by all means. I don't think it's a one size fits all type situation. But personally, I like peace of mind. I don't like messy situations. And I think being in a situation like that just opens the door to so much drama, so much headache, so many gray areas, having to sit down and having to figure things out that otherwise you wouldn't have to. So first of all, consider if you are the sort of person who can handle such an uncomfortable situation, because it is uncomfortable.
You being which party?
You being the person now dating your friend's ex and still staying friends with your friend. I think weigh up the options.
So you are the new guy.
I don't know, maybe you could have been friends with her before they got together. Just weigh up the options. I mean, which friendship do you cherish the most? Is it, you know, do you love Spikey more? Do you want to be best friends with Jifa? Like, consider, weigh up the options. If your friendship with Jifa, for example, holds more weight to you than exploring a relationship with Wilberforce, then by all means, just, you know, try and maneuver yourself out of there. But if, you know, it's such a strong connection that you feel like you have to explore, then perhaps your relationship might take a back seat. You guys might not be as close because it's awkward. Imagine your current partner mm-hmm. knowing intimate details about your best friend. That's a little too much. Hmm.
Intimate details about your best friend.
I mean, you're in a relationship. Mm-hmm. You've seen pretty much everything. You've seen them upset. You've seen them happy, you know, in other aspects as well. Hmm.
You've seen them naked.
Trying to be polite for a Friday morning, but okay.
No, it's okay. We play drums in the morning. I don't know how that's connected, but we can find a connection later.
Oh my God, all the thoughts. Yeah, so I mean, personally, yeah. I would be uncomfortable knowing that my best friend knows what my man looks like. That's a bit much for me.
Oh, you mean if they start dating subsequently?
Yeah, yeah. It's like you guys have all dated each other. Some and you're way. Still staying friends. It's
tripartite a bit, relationship.
It's a bit messy. It's a bit messy, personally. Oh,
what about love?
I mean...
And also the fact that maybe your best friend knows how your partner looks like naked... May not, I mean, someone else, before you even started dating him, mm-hmm. there probably have been other people who also know how
he
looks like.
You are not in close proximity to those people. Mm. I'm just trying to put myself in that situation, thinking about how I am with my friends. Mm-hmm. I don't necessarily like going out that much, but I do like a lot of socialization. I mean, I'll have...
So you wouldn't date Jifa's ex?
I couldn't. And then I'll still be friends with Jifa. And we'll be chilling. It'll be me, Jifa, and... her ex, who's now my man.
Yeah. Why?
No.
But you're all friends.
We're all friends, yeah, but it's a bit much. I don't hang out with my man's exes. Mm-hmm. So I don't see why I should. It's just too messy.
That's for the dating. Well, okay, so what happens when you find yourself falling in love with Jifa's ex, for instance?
So, it depends on the relationship I have with Jifa, first of all. Mm-hmm. Did I know him whilst he was with her? In, were we all in the same circle? I knew him. It depends on how long they've been broken up for. If it's like a year and if the connection is very, very, very strong, mm-hmm. I strongly believe this could go somewhere, then I'll have to have a conversation with my friend and let him know.
And what if you're confident that, you know what, this is Mr. Right, this is Mr. Super Duper Bobs, mm-hmm. and then Jifa tells you that, you know what, I don't want you to date him. What happens?
Then, if I strongly believe that that is my Mr. Right, uh-huh. then unfortunately, my friendship with Jifa will have to take a back seat. Unfortunately. Ooh. Unfortunately. If she's...
So you're choosing a guy over your girls.
I'm choosing love over a friendship. That's what it is. because if she really wants my happiness...
If he eventually breaks up with you, will you be able to face your friend?
I mean, it's something that's happened. It's a part of life. Mm. If we're able to rekindle our friendship, then that's all well and good. But
so
friendships have seasons.
To you, hey, friendship to flat come inside. Okay, wait. So Jifa comes to you crying. You mentioned this to Jifa, and then Jifa comes to you crying that, please don't do it. Please don't do it. Please, I still love him. Please don't do it. And then you still end up dating him because you two love him some.
That would be messy. I would let the guy know that Jifa still has feelings for him.
But you two have feelings for him.
I know, but I would still let him know that she has feelings for him. So if she's my friend, if he still has feelings for her, then they end up getting back together, then clearly I wasn't meant to be in that mix. But
so what if by then you and him have done something? Then what happens? And then, he decides, because of what you have said, if you hadn't said that Jifa still has feelings for him, he would not have maybe even thought about Jifa again. He would have moved on. Mm. But you are now doing pushing. Jifa has feeling for you. Now you've drawn his attention to his ex.
Yeah.
But now here you've done something already. Mm. So now he goes back to his ex. How you feel?
I mean, I'll have to just take it on the chin and work with it because that's my friend. Mm. You know, I don't call just anybody my friend, first of all. I mean, I have many acquaintances and I have very few friends. If this is my friend and I care about her, I love her, I have her best interest at heart, then I will tell him that she's still in love with him. And I mean, we don't all have to sit down together, but then he can
decide. By then, by you telling him that Jifa still has feelings for you, what are you hoping to achieve?
I'm not hoping to achieve anything. I'm just hoping it works itself out because now all the cards are on the table, all the facts are on the table.
So will you suspend operations with him?
Of course. I mean, she still has feelings for him. They have to explore that. They have to figure out if they still want to get back together. So I'll definitely take a back seat. But I'll also let her know that something's gone down, you know?
Okay, would it be easier for you, the third party or the friend, knowing that maybe the breakup was her fault? Maybe Jifa cheated on him, Mr. B. Let's just call him Mr. B. Jifa cheated on Mr. B several times. And then Mr. B eventually finds out, and you were Mr. B's friend even before Jifa came in the picture. Now Jifa is now very remorseful, but then still Mr. B is heartbroken, shattered, crying like a baby, comes to you, and then you guys eventually have some form of click. What happens? Is it okay now knowing that it was Jifa's fault?
Not necessarily. I don't know. I think it's all relative, isn't it? And also, it depends on if Mr. B has recovered from that whole relationship, because I certainly don't want to be some rebound chick, you know? So he needs to make sure that he's over that, even though he's hurt and upset. He's dealt with all of the baggage, the emotional baggage that has come with that situation before you move forward. I'm not saying just jump into anything blindly. By all means, like, you know, if you just want a bit of fun, that's on you. But I think if you're really
You can have a bit of fun with your friend's ex.
Oh my God. Wilberforce, no,
I'm not saying you personally. Yeah. I'm saying like generally.
Okay, I didn't say, I wouldn't recommend that because it brings unnecessary drama. I think people tend to be a little possessive over people they've been with. And knowing that your friend might be a little bit affected by knowing that you've been with their ex, it's a little messy. Just don't do it. I wouldn't ascribe to that unless it was a real connection. And then
now, you know. I described you. I put you in a position of a third party. Now I'm positioning you in the stead of the person who just broke up with someone.
Okay.
Is it okay for Jifa to date your ex if you were in that situation? Is it okay knowing some way? Yeah.
Is it okay? Yeah, so
any of your exes, even somebody you dated 4 years ago.
It depends on how close me and Jifa are, first of all. If we're like besties, she's known about this person, she knows the reason why we broke up, whether it was amicable or messy, and she still, okay, let's say it was messy, and she still decides to go for him, and she still decides to date him. I will wish you well. I'll wish you good luck, but I mean, that would be the end of our friendship. Because if it was a messy breakup, you know, I'm big on energy and surrounding myself with positivity. I will not want to be around that person. So if that's what you choose to do, then, you know, with love, I would say goodbye.
There's a theory that each person you break up with, you usually have something small. You have a small feeling for the person. It's not somebody that you just worked up with for fun.
Yeah.
Somebody that you love genuinely back then. So even though you've broken up, irrespective of the time, there's always something small there. Would you not agree with this?
I would say, you know that saying, there's a thin line between love and hate? I think even if you've loved someone and you have a soul connection with them, if you break up and it's on a bad note, that love could easily turn to hate. So,
and in the same way, if you hate that person, the thin line is still there.
And it could easily turn to love. Fair enough. But I think because of that inconsistency, I would much rather not have that person around me, especially if they're dating my friend, if I'm making any sense.
But then you still keep your friend and be laughing with your friend.
No, not necessarily. I mean, the friendship will definitely have to take a backseat. Like I was saying, I would love...
Because he's dating your ex?
That's what I was saying, that especially if we broke up on a bad note, I wouldn't want that negativity around me. And knowing that me and my friend are close, I see myself being a part of that equation. And I'd rather not invite negative energy into my life. So with love, I would say goodbye to my friend. Because if you know that someone and I broke up on such a sour note and you still decide to go after that person or you allow the person to come after you, then thumbs up, you know, by all means, explore, live your life. I just won't be a part of that equation.
Interesting. So then what then would be your advice to the whole whole Brazil Avenue thing going on where Mona Lisa just found out that her best friend is hooking up with her husband? Yes, Silas is hooking up with Olenka.
Oh my goodness.
What then would be your... I mean, she literally saw it. So this one is not like The best friend came to tell her that XYZ is going on. What then would be your advice to Mona Lisa?
Oh, divorce
him or forgive him?
Oh, definitely divorce. Oh, oh, my goodness. You see something like that, it's mm-hmm. imprinted in your mind. I could never. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'll definitely have the conversation, you know, sit everyone down, let them know that I know what's going on, but I definitely wouldn't stay in a situation like that.
Hmm.
That's degrading.
Oh.
Why would I put myself through that?
Forgive and forget.
Hey, no way. No, thank you.
Anyway, there's a message here. I will choose love over friendship. And well, no name is written here, but another message coming from Mabel. Mabel says, I agree perfectly with MFA Chikata on this particular occasion. And also another message here says, hello City TV, I'm really enjoying your program Breakfast Daily this morning. I'm Cyrus from Odoko. You guys are too much. Well, thank you very much, and thank you MFA Chikata for joining us on Breakfast Daily.
Thanks for having me.
It's always good to have you. Yeah. That's right. Anyway, so Breakfast Daily continues, don't go anywhere.